Hello, it's Sara, and this is it. We're going to create our March art journal page. So in the previous videos, this is our 2017 mixed media art journal that I'm creating a page a month or two. We'll see. Sometimes it's two. I did two for February. And March is going to be a piece that we're going to make with painted papers and collage. So we've already gone through and created a palette of papers that we've painted with our jelly print or by spraying it or however. I didn't demonstrate that. I only demonstrated the painter, the jelly plate. But you can use scrapbooking paper, any type of paper you want to do. I just have always loved collage. I don't know what it is about it. We're going to need some matte medium. And I use the Liquitex, and it's the fluid. I like it. It's like a glue, basically. And cut yourself out. I believe this is mixed media paper. I just get the pads from, Strathmore mixed media paper. 9 by 12, so I've cut it. So my sheets are 9 by 6. So I cut them in half, and that's the size of our art journal page. What we're going to do first is we're going to create some sky. So we want to make blues. So I've gathered up all the blue pages that I printed out, or, you know, that we mono printed on our jelly plate. And you just want to kind of start to tear and get some different color variations of blue. That's what I'm going to do. And I like the look of the jagged edge of a ripped page. So I'm going to shred up some papers, keep them all different sizes. Don't go too small because you'll be at it forever. And just start to make yourself, I'm going to go with the light blue now. A little, see, look at this. I went in with, I forget what color this is. This is called Deep Midnight Blue, just to have some color variation in there. So I'm just going to tear different sizes and shapes. This one looks like they're pretty square, but you can rip it in half and make two triangles. But don't go too small, I'm just saying. Make little piles, and we're going to do this for all your different blues. So see, that was a nice size. That's a nice size. Don't go too small. It'll take us forever. And then if you have little sandwich bags, you can save your colors in sandwich bags and have them for later. Let's go with, I want to see what some of those metallic-y, look at this. This had the metallic paint on it. I'm going to get a couple of those. This one definitely does. And it's lighter than those. And so this is a bit time consuming, and you probably don't need to see me do this. So I want you to go ahead and make yourself several piles of different colors of blues that you're going to use to create a sky. Alright, so I'm going to go away and do that. Also, go ahead and do that with your greens. So there was a little purple in this green, but mainly for my grass, my ground, I think I'm just going to stick with greens, like with a little green in it. Dark green, light green. This is a good one. It has light and dark. With the blue, I'm going to definitely include that. It'll play in with the, this is good. So all of these greens for your grass, create a few piles of greens, and then we're going to start adhering them to the page. Alright, so I'll be back when I have a few piles ready to go. Alright, all around me I have little piles that one I just blew, which, you know, but I tried to keep them in the colors that, you know, so if we're going to start with blue, let me move my blues over here. So I have some deli paper, some all different kinds of paper. I love this. This one deli paper is so gorge. Some of the darker colors. I got the really baby blue. That's on deli paper. And it doesn't matter what papers you put under, over, any of that stuff. Sometimes, I mean, with the deli paper, what's underneath may show through. Just go for it. Don't try to plan it out. This is part of being intuitive, okay? So that's what it means by intuitive. Don't think it through. I mean, yeah, you want to have a plan. You kind of want to, and I did go, because we are working on a small paper, you kind of do want your papers to be semi-small, not teensy tiny. I just didn't want to make you rip them up into, you know, pieces that are just beyond. And I've pretty much tried to rip off all of the white space so that we get mostly color. This seems like I forgot to do it on that one. All right, so let's start. I've got my matte medium on a piece of a small paper plate. And I'm just going to apply some matte medium to a section, just one quarter of the page, and just start applying your papers. I like to put matte medium on the back and front, and it can go over the edge. Just go over the edge, because we're going to trim everything down later. Now, the deli papers don't have to have it on the back and front as much, because they're thinner. It's a thinner... I really want to make sure I apply this over here so I don't get glue all over the... And I'm moving really fast. Take your time. Just do you. Be at your own pace. Enjoy the process. That's what it's about. And look, that actually looks like jeans. But look at this. This is so... I don't even want to... I want to wait till I get to the top, because I want to put that on top. Yeah, enjoy the process. What was I saying? And take as long as you would like to do this. This is not a race. I move fast. That's just me. I don't know why. And you don't need to know. It doesn't have to be. Like, this paper right here has writing on it. It can go up and down. I don't mind that. Sideways, sure, why not? I'm gonna put a little piece of this in the corner over here. And I started out putting it on the backs too, but you know, this is so gorge. I really want to wait. Let's put some light blue right here. And again, that's deli paper, so I don't... Depending on the consistency of your paper, be careful, because, and I'm so rough, you see me being, I am not slow or gentle when it comes to this stuff. So just know that I will rip things, you know, I know I will, because that's just what I do. I'll cover that up. So see how I'm kind of trying to, let's put one of these gorgeous pieces in the middle. I'm trying to... too big right here. Fill up the space and use a variety of color and different types of paper. Let's cover that whole section. And that's what I love, the texture of it. And you know, it's not for everyone, but look at this sky. That is one cool looking sky, if you ask me. Oh, I have this over here. This is like a deli paper. And I'm going to try not to overlap too much. I don't want to get too bulky. But I like that. I didn't remember I had that. There's a little pile off to the side. Now, I didn't have nearly as much green. So I have fewer colors of green. But I'm going to do a littler section, so it's okay. Let's do that there, and go right off the edge, because we're going to trim it up. And even if it wrinkles, it's okay, because that adds texture, and that's the fun of collage, honestly. And if you don't like it, don't do it, guys. I just try to share with you some of what I've learned, and I've been seeing a lot of this. I think her name is Chelsea, and those of you who don't know about Chelsea, she does a lot of voiceover ones, so it's not a lot of real time, or she'll have a little bit of real time in there with a sped up video, but she does her own sketches. It's all her own work, and she's fantastic. She's a really good artist, but she paints with paper. That's what this is called. And the way I wish she'd do like a real step-by-step version of it, because she doesn't. She doesn't explain it exactly. You know me. I like to know everything and when I learn. But I'm kind of getting the feel for it. I'm kind of understanding what she's going for. And we're going to do a little bit of what I think she does when we do our tree and possibly our bird and everything else. I'm going to do a little bit of it as to the best I can. Need a little more medium. I'm going to take it just out like about to right here. And then we're going to start doing our grass. And see, that looks the same. I don't like when I do the same right near something that I just did. A little bit of this over here. So we're getting there. I think I'll do a little bit more here. What else? Now the interesting thing I was thinking about when I did this was, how am I going to get my horizon line to look kind of distinct and separate from the skyline, you know? So I'm still debating if I want to do the skyline let me stop so I can think and tell and talk to you about what I want to do. I want to make look like a line. So I'm thinking if I glued the green papers to another, like maybe a piece of deli paper, and then just adhered that whole piece of deli paper, it would be able to have, I could cut the top of it. So that's where I think I'm headed. I think I want to add something right here. I think a piece of this gorgeousness. This little piece of gorgeousness. So you see what I'm saying? But I think I'm done my sky as I keep going, right? It's just addictive, I'm telling you. It's hard, very hard to stop for me. I get in the groove and man, I think I want to do this. All right, I gotta stop. Alright, so I'm going to put my brush in my water. I'm going to stop and have a look. But isn't that so cool? So that's going to be our sky. And we're going to be able to paint over it and calm it down. Maybe we'll do a little gesso. I have to see. I have to see if I just love it, because I love it. I love all that color and texture. So I am going to get my blues out of the way now and get my greens. But do I want to do it on a separate piece? I kind of think I do, guys. This is what I'm talking about. Let me just move these blues, and I'm going to put them in a little baggie for later, a blue. So this is all my blue painted papers that I'll use. And I'm going to pull these greens into the shot now. here's what I'm thinking. If I take a piece of deli paper and I cut like a horizon line, and that, no, I'm not even going to cut it yet. Aha, that's a good point. So I'm going to all I'm going to cover, oopsie, I don't want that to stick. I'm going to set that aside to dry, and when it dries, we'll just trim all the edges. So I'm going to set it over here. We're going to cover this definitely from the top, and I'll measure it in a minute. So we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to cover this deli paper. And I hope this works out. I've never done this before. I'm going to bring in, get some more matte medium going, and do the same thing with dripping. With the greens. I want to see what this is going to be. Oh, it's going to be fine. The deli paper holds pretty good. So just start applying these different colors. I just like to put it on the back too. But definitely put it on the front. When you put it on the front, it kind of adheres. And I'm adding a little bit of this purple in here, the green with the purple, to kind of make it look like there's some flowers maybe popping in from somewhere, some of those little bluebells or something that are coming up for spring. Thank goodness, I'm so ready for spring, yay. I went for my run tonight with the group from Herbalife. It was so fun. Good group of people. Lots of people were there. It was my first time, and there were kids. Moms brought their kids, and it was just great. It was a good group, and the guy that runs it, he's made for this because he was so inspirational and kept track of everybody and made sure you're okay. So it was awesome. We're building up to do what is it called? It's only 3.2 miles, however far that is. I've never done anything like that, so I'm looking forward. It's on June 1st, so I'm thinking of doing that. Let me put a piece of purple over here. And I gotta go up a little higher. Definitely gotta go up higher. Because I'm gonna cut this into a kind of just a little horizon line, you know? Oops. But I've been seeing these painted papers and looking at them, and no one really does tutorials, you guys, like I do. Like I do a real, see that? I missed some spot. Like teach you how to do it so that you can do it yourself. And I guess I get that because maybe they don't want you to really know how to do it, so they can be the only one to do it. And then if they are teaching you how to do it, maybe it would be more in a workshop, which I told myself I was going to try and do. See, I need more dark green. I wanted to see if I was going to list some of these classes on, what was it, Vimeo, but I never did. I mean, there's still one polymer clay class that I want to do. It's polymer clay applique on an Altoid tin. So I haven't done the class yet, so I'm still deciding if I wanna. That looks exactly the same. Let's put the purple. If I want to do it on Vimeo or not. So I just haven't decided, because I could do it for free. You know, that's the thing. that's what I love about YouTube, is sharing what we learn with each other, you know? I think I'm, oops, running out of some of these colors. Yeah, I definitely didn't get as much green as I thought. What I mean, my deli papers, or my, not my deli papers, my painted papers. But I'm sure I'll make it. I have plenty here. It's just not going to be as diversified. And Maya's here tonight, and she doesn't have school tomorrow. But she's upstairs watching some movie. But I hear her, so I'm wondering if she's going to bust in on me. And let me see. Ooh, this one's cool. Has a little mark on it, like I did some type of mark making to it. That was cool. I like that. Let's find another piece of that. See, I don't have very many. Put that right here. And another purple. Gotta put a few more purples. We're getting there, guys. And when I'm done this, I think I'm gonna take a break, because it's 10:30 at night right now. But Joe's in Washington, so I have the time, and I was awake, feeling pretty good. But I gotta go take a shower, and I'll get right back to this tomorrow morning. So this one has some cool dark green and light green. Here she comes. I hear her. She's going to bust in. I knew it. Hey, Mama.
Oh, hello.
I'm filming. What you doing? I chop it. I'm making a collage paper. I want you. What do you think of this? What do you think
of this? Cool.
Thank you. We talk baby talk. So the people are listening, but I'm just chatting as I fill in these spaces. This is called what? Do you know what this is called, Maya, when you glue a bunch of papers down like this? Do you have any clue?
Gluing papers and gluing. Collage.
Yes. Yeah. Collage. This is exactly white. Alright, I think we're getting there. I gotta measure. I gotta see if this is gonna cover the bottom of my page. What do you think?
Oh, you did this one?
That's the sky, and this is the ground.
Oh, that's
cool.
Cool,
right? Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is.
Cool. I like this color.
I know. It's all painted papers that I made.
You made those papers?
Yeah. I just smooshed some paper, some color on there. All right, a little bit right here.
It's a pretty color, though.
Thank you, Maya. You're my best friend. What? Well, it's chilly. Go stand by the heater.
Oh, like this.
Well, that's okay. Everybody has that, Maya. Everybody has that. All right, hold on. All right, we're good. So let me see.
Did you finish your shape?
Yes, I did. And I had a few pieces of ham.
Oh.
Because I didn't eat all my calories today.
What does that mean?
I had to eat more food. All right, so let's see. I've been what?
Eating fish.
Yes, I have, and I'm very happy about it.
So, oh, that's cool.
Does it look like? Yeah, it definitely does. All right, so here's what I'm thinking. I'm going to go away for a minute and get this dry, because I want to be able to cut it into a kind of a little hill looking.
Are you going to put like a house or something?
No, we're going to do this. It's a good question. We're going to make a tree, a bird, and some flowers, because I painted a bunch of papers and I'm going to use those colors. See that? I'm making a bird. I'm going to make some flowers. All right, so I'll be right back. Everybody dry everything, and then we're going to cut it and put it on and be done with our background for tonight. So I'll be right back. All right, so they're not dry, but I should be able to cut it. Let's see how it goes. If not, I'll have to wait till tomorrow and really let it dry. But they're, I just used my my heating tool, what's it called? My embossing gun. and just went over it for a few seconds. Yeah, this isn't really cutting super easily because it's definitely still a little damp. And these are Recollection scissors. Maybe if I use my Tim Holtz scissors. And I'm just using the guideline of the end of the edge of the page and just gently going down and trimming off the pieces that hung over the edge. Yeah, I mean, it's working fine. It's even though it's not completely dry. And I can see white spaces where I actually, that's just the edge of the paper because we tore it. So, but we're going to put this on. Hold on. Let's see. So here's what I want to do. I'm going to adhere this about like right here. But I'm going to create my horizon line. So let me use, I'll use a pen. I was going to use pencil, but I want you guys to be able to see it. So I'm just going to use my Uniball Vision. And I kind of want to go with, so I have to go like this, right? I want it a simple curve. So I'm going to use this as my guide and start at the top of where these, make sure I have enough. Yeah, I have plenty. All right, it has to be right here is the bottom. Yeah, I have plenty. So I'm going to start here and just make it a curve. Something like that. So you can see that, right? Yeah. And then I'm going to cut that. Yeah, it's cutting. It's a little rough. It's a little soft, you know what I mean? But it worked. I like it. I think it's good. Yeah, I'm not sure that I like that ink band there, though. Let's see. Because it'll smudge. I'm just wiping it off before I smudge it. Alright, so now I'm going to adhere this down onto, but look at, I wanted to show you this. Look at the back of the paper, how cool that is. I love it. I love collage. So fun. So those are my scraps. Alright, so let me get a little bit more matte medium. And we're going to cover the bottom of this paper with a good coat of matte medium. I think I want to put it on here first. I don't know why. But I'm going to put it on the back of the grass and the front of the mixed media, the journal page. So I'm just going to quickly coat this again. And then go ahead and put it all on the open area, on the grass area. You know where to put it. Make sure you go right up to the edges, though. That's your main. We can always stick a little glue under there. And I'm just going to line this up how I had it, kind of, sort of, like that, and stick it down. I have plenty. Okay. I'm just going to cut this away. Not like perfect yet, but just so that I kind of have an idea where I'm going. Because having that much hanging over isn't really helpful. I'm going to get a baby wipe and get this glue off here. And maybe even grab a paper towel. All right, because right now I really want to make sure this adheres, and I could probably use my brayer since it's still out here and give it a little roll to just get that adhered And I don't know, I might have to take my, I'm gonna take a little more matte medium and just go right down the edge. And I think I'm gonna leave this to dry overnight, and then I'm gonna come back and trim it off tomorrow just to make sure it's adhered. Maybe go over it too on the front. But that should be good. And if you guys have Mod Podge, Mod Podge is a great adhesive. Just got a bunch of matte medium on here. So Mod Podge would work nice too. I'm gonna just go, you know what, I really don't have to go over it. I think I'll just go over this little, where this joins up. Because I don't know if I really put it under there. Put a coat along that horizon line. And don't worry about it looking like a horizon line right now, because at the end, or as we go, I'm going to add shading to it, and we'll get it look, you know, we're going to put our tree on and our sun and our bird and all that stuff. But so far so good. This is exactly what I was hoping for, and it's super easy, right? You just have to gather up a few painted papers first, and you're on your way to a masterpiece. All right, so I don't know how many parts this stinking art journal page is going to be, but I really love it. And adding those metallic or pearl paints in there, it just adds so much fun. And then, I mean, if you haven't gotten any of them in, you can come back and stencil them on later. All right. You know what's funny is I don't really have any music paper in the sky, and I have a lot of music paper in the grass. I don't know why that just hit me. I have a lot more words in the sky, and there's no words in the grass. A little bit, but I painted over it much more. Alright you guys, so that's it. We're going to set that, let it dry overnight, and I can't wait to get back to it tomorrow, alright? So I'll see you. Thanks for watching. Alright, we're back. So, I've had time to think about it, and I think you're going to need deli paper, because that's how we're going to create the rest of our design. The way that we did the grass, which I can cut that now. Everything's dry. And it was a little warpy, so I bent it a little bit, but we're going to be creating the rest of our design by doing the same thing we just did with the grass, gluing the colored papers onto deli paper. And I thought of a way we're going to do that. And I was telling you about Shell C. And now that I think about it, I see her doing this in her videos. By taking a piece of deli paper, so what I'm going to do is lay this out. I'll just go bigger. No, wait a minute. Let me think. I am going to butt it right up against the edge of the page. I'm going to take my pen, well, my pencil, and sketch out the design the way I want to do it. So I'm going to make the tree. We're going to have a few flowers here. I may just use a punch to punch out the flowers. Let's just focus on the tree and the bird. We're going to have a sunshine. So I'm going to have a sun. Just a little one. And the tree, I'm going to make the tree a little bit wider than I had originally thought, and it could have even, well, kind of come over to the side like the roots are going that way. But then when we do the branch, hopefully you can see, let me zoom in. Maybe I should have used the marker. I can use a marker, because you know why? I'm gonna flip, hold on, let me think. Yeah, you'll be able to see it through. Sorry, I haven't done this before, so I gotta, you know. All right, I'll use this pretty blue Sharpie. All right, so now I gotta go back up. Sorry, a lot of stories. All right, Q. kiwis with me too. Alright, so we're going to go down and have a tree that kind of goes like this. And I'm going to have a bird, and here's a sun. And I want my birdie to be like right about here. And I'm going to try and go a little smaller, but you know me, I go big or go home. So I'm making my branch kind of come down like this. And it can go off the page. And that's kind of thick. Actually, I want my tree to be wider then. So ignore this. We'll do that. My bird is going to be a little smaller than I always have a hard time. So to make your bird, you just make a U shape. And just keep it simple. So that's your bird. You can make a nest. We could make a nest for our bird. And he's a little wonky. I don't love the shape. But all right, and then we're gonna have flowers here. But the main idea, so now you have the design. You can see that? Not totally great, but so now you have your design on this deli paper. We're going to set our background aside. I went ahead and did some brown paper palette. Sorry for my reach. I did a couple pages, just a couple of browns, because I knew we were going to do that tree, and how are we going to do a tree without browns? So I got to rip all this up. And then we're going to glue it to the top of the design. I'm going to go right over. So I should have done my bird in a different area. Anyway, this is my first time doing it, guys. So what can I tell you? Let me see also, did I stop at... yeah, so this is right about the top. All right, good. I'm going to rip up these browns. Look how gorgeous. I thought I filmed this, and then when I went and checked today, I couldn't find, I don't know where it is, so my bad. But I did just go ahead and take, I think there was 4 different browns. I did a really dark brown and a really, really light tan, burnt sienna, and I think there were 4 different ones. Just to get variation, and I just made little marks in it. So that's it, nothing major. And so again, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'll come back when this is all ripped up and I'll show you what I'm gonna do. All right, I've got my piles of brown. I'm gonna get out some matte medium again. And this time, we just wanna cover this area where the tree is with browns, all different kinds of browns, and I may be ripping up the brown a little smaller than yesterday. We'll see. So you can see my design, especially here. We're going to need some small pieces, but I'm going to start with the main trunk and just start putting it down. Now, you want to overlap again, because that's going to keep it the pattern, or not the pattern, but the shape of the tree. Nice. We'll be able to cut off the excess, and it'll just be the perfect shape. So you get it, right? You see where I'm going with this. And I have these really light colors. Overlap. Don't forget to put some book pages too, so that you have all the different textures. This is a little bit of graph paper. I think I'll put smaller pieces of that to fill in here. And I'm rushing. I'm doing this very quickly. I'm not really trying to think too much about it. And so because I keep talking about this intuitive style of painting, that everyone seems to do in Wonderlust, and it really it is helpful, because you can think too much. You can overthink things. So just whatever happens, happens. And I think you could be surprised with happy accidents. And then you can tweak things after you see where that takes you. Then you progress. Oops, make sure it's stuck down. I don't know, I'm gonna stop. Now look, here's a piece of blue and we'll probably see through that. So I wanna go over it with kind of an opaque paper. So I'm gonna put that right there. And then I'll have to cover because there's a lot of the same right here. I'll put a piece of this right here to kind of break that up. This is so cool, you guys. I've been wanting to try this for a while. And it, you know, this is the thing. Stuff just hits me. It just comes to me. And that's why, and I'm doing it right now for the first time with you. And figuring it out as I go. And it's not that hard. It's really, you know, it makes sense. Oop, there's Kiwi on my shoulder. You want to come down and see everybody? Come down on my arm. So for the branch, I am being a little more small. Trying to, anyway. Let's go darker. So you can see through that. I mean, actually, I'm going to cut on the line there, so it won't be a big deal. What else? Are we good? I like the white edges of the paper showing too. That looks pretty cool. So now I'm just going to overlap with something right there, this dark brown. For some reason, when I do this, it's very meditative, and I am in a zone, and I don't talk. Like, it feels very zen, if that makes any sense. Like, I just feel so calm, and I forget that I'm, like, that you're there. So, sorry about that. There's really nothing to tell you about it. It's just gluing paper down. But see how it's, we have the shape of our tree. And we're going to come back and add paint to this too. You know how I like to do my shading and, oops, make sure that's not stuck. Okay. I like to do my shading with floats. So I will be doing that to... get our final real shapes and make sure everything looks in perspective. Does that make sense? Looks in perspective. Hi, Kiwi. Oh, she's on my ear. A little bit more graph paper right here. And book page. No, graph paper. No, this stuff. I am really proud of myself, though, because I am just being intuitive. I'm not thinking about this. And I'm just letting it happen. And it's happening. And I did that really quick. I'm going to put a little book page right here because that's the corner. Now, we have to let this dry. I'm going to let it dry. But if we look at the back, we can still see our design. See, so I'm going to cut that out, and that'll be our tree. So let's see. I'm going to do a different, the bird in a different spot. And I didn't really love that bird. And I'm going to have to go away and cut up, rip up some pinks and reds, because I want my bird to be red. So I'm going to use that pink and red. But let's just draw a cuter bird. I want it to be, you could put an owl. Maybe we should make an owl. I've never done an owl. I'm going to make an owl. All right, so he's going to be just a U shape with some ears like this. And then he's, we'll make a nose on him like that and some big eyes. And maybe some wings like this. I like it. I don't like the shape of that one. So I'm going to do it again. So do as many as it takes. I think I want my owl to be a little taller. I want him to be taller and thinner. I liked his ears. And his eyes are going to be up high. His nose and then some wings. He's not the best looking owl I've ever seen. Let me do one more. I'm going to look. I have some owls here on my board. All right. So he's going to be a little more U-shaped like this. And we'll just do a scoopy ear like this. Ah, I like that better. And then we'll just do the circles like this. And a little nose. We're not worried about this. I'm just seeing what it's going to look like. And the wings. I think my wings could actually be wider. Well, you know what? We're going to do wings that come off the body like this. So for right now, we're just going to do... Boy, I'm going to do one more. So keep making an owl till you like what you get. I got to get this glue off of here. All right, but I think I'm on to something now. I think I know where I'm going with this owl. So we don't want him too big. Got to look at your bird here. So he's going to be a U shape and just connect. And that's it. That's all I'm going to do. And we're going to do this whole thing pink. Or red, or whatever color, a purple owl, that works for me too. He's kind of fat, but I like him. I think that's going to be too big. I like him. All right, we're going to go with a big owl, a big fat owl. And then we're going to do a sun. So I'm going to put my sun up here. I had him on that other page, and I kind of lost it. So actually, let me put this on top of here. I have enough room. Okay, cool. So I'm going to do a sun like right here. And I'm going to use those that yellow and some orange paper for that. So I'm going to rip up some pinks and reds and yellows. And I'll be right back. Okay, so I have a lot of great red. I went crazy with the pinks and reds, you know, you saw that, because I love those colors. But for the sun, I'm seeing a lot of yellow mixed in with the reds and pinks, so I'm kind of going to pull that out for my sun. I had this really good couple of pieces, and I could just make the whole sun with this, but I'm going to, oh, these are so gorgeous. I'm going to do it, though. I'm going to rip this one. And I'm going to use this for my sun because it has a lot of yellow in it. We'll see. I mean, suns aren't really pink, but let's see. Like, this has yellow. That's really gorgeous. This is a lot of yellow, too. Let's see. So I'll use the more yellowy pieces. So I'm just going to make a little pile of that and save the pink. Like, this little piece of yellow has a little bit of pink with it, but I think I'm going to use that in my sun. So I'll just have a few little, because the sun's a very small piece, so it won't take me but a few pieces of paper to cover it. So I'll just use a few of those. All right, but I just wanted to show you, if you know, because I do have all this yellow that has blue in it, but this is great. And this was actually on here. I pulled this off of here. There was just a nice piece of yellow. All this yellow and orange actually is great for my son. So all this stuff. Kiwi, you want to come up? Where are you? Come on. Come. Nope, she's all right. She's sitting on the back of my chair. I love having her with me when I'm doing this. She's a sweet little bird. All right, and then this is the deli paper, which is so cool. But yeah, because it's such a small sun, I'm not going to need a ton of paper. So I'll just rip a few pieces of this. And a couple, like, I love, this has a little bit of that, that roller stamp that I went over it with. So I'm going to rip a couple of those. Try to get the yellow. All right, but I think that's plenty for my sun. So let's just do the sun. And then which one am I going to do? Where did my... I guess I was going to do this guy. And I was even thinking of doing a purple owl because I think this purple... I think I might do a purple owl because I got a lot of purple. So I'm going to come back when these are all done and we'll cut out our tree, but you don't need to watch me do this. I'm just going to glue down yellow and red papers to the sun and probably purple, I think, for my owl. I don't know. I'll have to decide. All right, I'll be back. So I decided to do my owl purple, and I ran out of purple. I only had two pages of purple, two little things of purple, and they're both very similar. So I'm just looking through my book in here and seeing if I can find some good purple pages. I don't know what's in here. This looks kind of purpley. Look at that. I think I might use that. Some of these stick together, so I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, but I think I'm going to use this. Because this is like, it has metallic on it. I really like that. So I'm going to I'll just take that out. And let's see what other purple I can find. Look at this. That's kind of a lot of, oops, hold on, there we go. This is a good purple right here. So I'll use that. And that other side looked pretty good too. But I just, you know, don't forget about, look at that. That's cute. This right here. I like this. So that's why these come in handy. I thought I made enough colors to... Ooh. Look at that purple and blue. I may need to use that for sure. Let me just rip this out. All right, so that should be enough now because the owl isn't very big either. But this just looked too similar. I must have used the purple and the light green. And I tried to go for this book page, but it really had very little purple on it. It's mostly white. See, here's my son. But look at this. This has, especially like this one, look how gorge. And this is also metallic paint. So I'm going to rip this into pieces. And look at that. Because it's just so different from this. I'm just going to set this aside for a sec and get some of this. And this is even a little pinky purple. But I like it a lot. But it has that metallic. So I'll even get some, and like the blue lines of the, it's like just notebook paper. The writing lines are even showing through it, and it just looks so cool. So this should be enough for my little owl, but I just wanted to show you, if you don't have any, look, that's why it's good to have a little book like that. So you can go through and find your scraps. Like this is even a more lavender color. So now I have plenty of purple to work with. Just because I had used my, I just went over my brayer. I went over the paper with my brayer. So here's my little owl. I ended up making them taller. I like this shape better. Where did I leave my brush? So I'm just going to cover him with some of these papers. I'm actually ripping these up a bit smaller because it's such a small little owl to make sure. Let's try and put one of these book pages in here. Even though there's really not much purple on there. Because I'm going to attach a wing to the sides of him too. So we'll probably, you know, you never know what you're going to go over. But just because, like, I was looking at my sky and stuff, and I thought, well, I have to fill in there, I have to fill in. But you don't, because we've, you know, wait until the end, and we'll fix it with paint, or then you can add a piece of paper if you really need to. But I think just wait until you're done so you can see the overall effect and tweak it at the end. I love it. I'm so happy with this. It's so fun, you guys. Like, I really wasn't sure where I was going with this, you know. I knew I had a couple things in mind for an art journal page. The intuitive, and let me find another piece of this with some purple. And the paper painting. Well, I knew I wanted to do collage because I haven't been doing a lot of collage with my mixed media. And this is just so, I just am so glad I thought of this and that I am sharing it with you guys. What else? How about, I think we're good. And I love everything about this, the textures of the paper, the patterns, the just everything. It's so awesome. Wait, a little more darker purple. Or the feather. A feather just blew down. So I want to put a little more of the this. But see, there's real, oh, here's a piece. Here's a little piece of purple. Just want to put this like right here. Alright. So let's go back to our tree. I'm going to put all these. My desk is, I'm going to have to organize this because I've just been rushing and excited to get it done and I have paper everywhere. So, alright, let's let this set this aside to dry. Oopsie. This is my owl and my sun. The sun's pretty dry, but I'm going to set that aside and get our tree, which should be pretty good by now. Can't find it. Look, my desk is a total paper pile. Can't find my tree. Oh, Lord. Here it is. So here's our tray. It feels pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and try to cut it. So we're going to flip it over and cut along that line that we made. You want to come up? Okay, come up. Here she comes. Be careful, because if it's wet, let it dry before you start cutting it out so that you don't tear it. Let's see what we have. What do we have, Kiwi? What do we have? We've got a tree. I love it. All right. So I am going to glue this down. Kind of goes off. I wish it would have went straight up. I don't know why. I'll turn it like this. All right, so we're gonna, again, just using our matte medium or Mod Podge or whatever you have, put glue along this side of the paper. And yours doesn't have to be on this side. You could put it on this side if you know. Well, that wouldn't look right. But I would have drawn it on that side, just to say, make it your own. And let's stick it down. There's paper all over the place. Get out of here. Get out of here, like Donald Trump said. Get him out of here. What a maroon that guy is. He's a maroon. All right, so put it on your piece, too. You get that double stick, you'll have better luck getting it to stick. And then line it up on the edge of your page like that. And stick it down. Stick it down. Get it as stuck as you can, and then go over it with the matte medium too. Gotta stick it down real good. Come back and apply where you need it. Make sure it gets stuck. Right, Kiwi? Right? Just give it a second to adhere. I'm going to wipe this off. Hold on, Kay. Hold on. One-handed taking out a baby wipe isn't easy when it's almost empty. Stupid thing. Just going to make sure it's up against on the edges. Just make sure you have plenty so it doesn't come off your edges. And I'm going to take the brayer and do that, get a matte medium all over it, but I like to use the brayer to kind of give it that, oops, see, I pulled it off. It's very sticky right now. Well, not sticky, because matte medium doesn't get sticky. That's what I like about it. But I'm just going to set that aside and let it dry. Look how cool. I'm so excited. This is so fun. You can kind of see some blue through there. So I'm just going to take a little piece of the brown, which is, I'm going to use like a lighter. Just cover that. There we go. Anywhere the blue is coming through, I'm going to cover it. But make sure you don't go over the edge so that you still have that nice line. And right here. I think that's good. Maybe a little bit over here. Use this dark brown. Now the edge over here we can do because we're going to cut that off in a minute. I'm going to trim this up when it dries. All right. OMG. OMG. This is so cool. I want to do a big one. I'm getting excited. All right. So let's go ahead and work on Well, let's see. We did our, let's see if these are dry enough to cut out. I don't know. Oh yeah, our sun definitely is. So again, just take, turn it over and cut along the line that you drew on your deli paper. And there's your sun. And here's my owl. I'm gonna let him dry a little more because the deli paper is still really wet. But you can see that he's all covered with paper. I'm gonna just let him dry. Let's go ahead and put the sun on. What the heck? I am so impatient and this is so exciting. I can't wait for things to dry. Oh my gosh! All right, sorry, a little too much happiness. And then I'm gonna go away while the owl dries and get and just clear my desk off. I have so much stuff on my desk. It's, ugh. I'm gonna get some baggies and I'm gonna put my colors in the baggies so that I can always just grab it and pick papers out of the baggie. So I need to, I mean literally, my desk is covered with paper right now, so. I actually have some stuff left from jelly printing last night that I could get off my desk, and I really like working on a cleanish desk. It helps me a lot. So just if you guys ever feel blocked or anything, clean your space and the inspiration may just happen because it just, I don't know, I love it. It makes me feel happy when my space is cleared. But look at that gorgeous sun. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. So is our bird gonna fit there? He's kind of big. Yeah, he's gonna fit. He's gonna be gorgeous. And then we're gonna put a couple flowers down here. I haven't figured that out yet, and I think I'm gonna work with the pinks and bring that down. That's why I went with purple. So design-wise, it wasn't pink. It was, so I wanna, you have to move things around. And then we'll add some more green leaves up here, have some peeking out and stuff. It's gonna be so cute. OMG, I'm gonna let this dry and I'll be back.